Now I will explain question number 12. Question number 12. Find the values of x, y and z from the following figure. Means from this figure we have to identify value of x, value of y and value of z. Now see, consider this angle x and angle 55. Both are exactly opposite to each other and they cannot have any common arms. So angle x and angle 55 both are vertically opposite angle. Means 55 degree and angle x are VO angle. And already we proved that vertically opposite means VO angle are equal. We know that VO angles are equal. Means whatever measurement of this 55 degree, it is also measurement of angle X. So angle X is equal to 55 degree. So X is equal to 55 degree we identify. Now see in this figure, angle X and angle Y both are linear pair because they have this common arm and these non-common arms are exactly opposite to each other and they form exactly half circle. So angle X and angle Y both are linear pair. Angle X and angle Y are linear pair. And we know that sum of measures of linear pair is 180 degree. So angle X plus angle Y is equal to 180 degree. Now value of X, we know X is equal to what? 55 degree. So instead of X, I will write here 55 degree. So 55 degree plus angle Y is equal to 180 degree. Here we have to identify angle Y. So 55 degree side we have to change. This side 55 degree side is plus. So this side it become minus 55 degree. So angle Y is equal to 180 minus 55 degree. So angle Y is equal to this 180 minus 55 degree. So here 10, 5, here 7. So its answer is Y is equal to 125 degree. So angle Y is equal to what? 125 degree. Now you see the angle Y and angle Z. Angle Y and angle Z both are exactly opposite to each other and they cannot have any common arms. Means angle Y and angle Z both are vertically opposite angle. So angle Y and angle Z both are VO angle. And already we proved that vertically opposite angles are equal. So whatever measurement of angle Y, it is also measurement of angle Z. Because angle Y and angle Z both are vertically opposite angle. And already we proved that vertically opposite angles are equal. So angle Y is equal to angle Z is equal to 125 degree. So in this way, we identified angle X, angle Y and angle Z. Now, second question of question number 12. In second question, this figure is given to us. And we have to identify angle Y, angle Z and angle X. Here, two measurements is given to us, 40 degree and 25 degree. So in this question, you see these two lines, here to here, means 40 degree and this angle Z. See, 40 degree and angle Z both are exactly opposite to each other and they cannot have any common arms. Means 40 degree and angle Z both are vertically opposite angle. So angle Z measurement is also 40 degree. So see, 40 degree and angle Z both are vertically opposite angles. And we know that vertically opposite angles are equal. So angle Z is equal to also 40 degree. So angle Z we identify 40 degree. Now we will see in this figure, angle Y and angle Z both are linear pair. See, this here to here means angle Y and angle Z. This is common arms and their non-common arms are exactly opposite to each other. Means angle Y and angle Z both are linear pair. Angle Y and angle Z are linear pair. And we know that sum of measurement of linear pair is 180 degree. Means angle Y plus angle Z is equal to 180 degree. 180 degree. Sorry, by mistake I spoke first 80 degree, but right is angle Y plus angle Z is equal to 180 degree. Now here we know the measurement of angle Z is equal to 40 degree. So instead of Z, I will write 40 degree. So angle Y plus 40 degree is equal to 180 degree. We have to identify angle Y. So 40 side we have to change. This side it become plus. So if we change its side, so it become minus this side. So angle Y is equal to 180 degree minus 40 degree is equal to 140 degree. So angle Y is equal to 140 degree. So angle Z we identified it is 40 degree. Angle Y we identified it is 140 degree. Now we have to identify angle X. See how we identify angle X. See here. This is the straight line. This is the straight line. So this angle and this angle means 40 degree, angle X and angle 25. These all three angles can form a straight line. And we know that measurement of straight line is 180 degree. Means 25 degree plus angle X plus angle 40 degree is equal to 180 degree. Because they can form exact half circle here. See, this is straight line, this angle and this angle exactly form half circle. So sum of measurement of 25 degree, angle X and angle 40 is equal to 180 degree. So 40 degree plus angle X plus 25 degree is equal to 180 degree. Now we have to identify angle X. So 25 degree and 40 degree side we change. This side both side is plus. So if we change its side, this side it become minus. So X is equal to 180, this side 40 degree plus, so minus 40 degree, this side plus 25, it become minus 25. So X is equal to 180 minus 40, so 140 degree and minus 25. So X is equal to 140 minus 25. So here 3, 10, 10 minus 5, then 5, 3 minus 2, then 1 and this. So angle X is equal to 115. So final answer, angle X is equal to 115. So this is the solution of second question of question number 12. I hope you understand.